I've come to a new suburban development near Parramatta in New South Wales in response to a letter I've got here from the Priestley family. Now, they write about their two terriers. They've got Bobby and they've got Toby. Now, Toby's fairly normal, but Bobby, he loves ball games. But then come to think of it, I don't think love is quite the right word. Anyhow, you'll see what I mean.
I can see one dog. Here comes the family.
How you going?
Hi, how you going?
Andrew. Good
Hi.
To see you, mate.
Good to see you.
Kate.
How are you?
Mum, right? And Malcolm, Dad. All right.
Nice to meet you.
And here's the other dog. Now, which dog is the problem dog?
Bob.
Everybody points at the tan and white dog. Let's go in and see what this dog gets up to. So tell me what happens on that video table.
Well, whenever we pick up a pool cue or whenever we hit a ball, our tan and white dog, Bob, he goes absolutely berserk. He starts jumping up and down. He is yelping like it hurts him. It's not pleasant to see, really. It first started when we got the pool table 18 months ago. The first few times he was fine, but after that he started to get very worked up, and now it's grown into a full problem that you can't even pick up a pool cue without him going berserk.
How's the reaction to table tennis?
Just as bad. If you pick up a ping pong ball and bounce on the table, he just goes as crazy. He does the same thing. He jumps up, he yelps. It's almost as though it's physically hurting him.
And Toby, how does he react to all of this going on?
Well, he's normally calm. He doesn't have a problem with the table at all.
What are you doing to try and solve this?
We've tried giving him his own ball to play with because they love playing with balls, but that doesn't work. We've tried putting him outside, putting him in a room upstairs, but he still goes crazy. We've tried putting him in a car outside. We've tried a few different things, but nothing's worked.
He would do quite a bit of damage. This is, well, it's the paddle and not our hand, isn't it?
Yes, I know, that's the thing.
This dog is anxious about something he can hear but can't see. He has the terrier drive to get it and catch it, and in his case, rip it to shreds. So without some sort of medication to even up this behaviour pattern, right, we're done. But I'm going to show you the principles of what I want you to do once we've got medication established and in place for about a month. That goes over there. Big thing goes underneath the belly. That goes in there. This is an essential, the lead, because without that, you've got no control over the dog. We're going to undergo, or try to undergo, a process of desensitisation. In other words, get the dog used to balls being bounced around on tables.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So how do we do that? Well, initially, we go away where the dog can hardly hear what's going on. We give the dog a simple command, like sit.
Sit. Good boy.
You reward the dog for good behaviour and you come closer and closer. But it'll be a slow process and it'll take you 20 minutes a day because this is not a normal dog. This is a dog that vacillates between two extremes, okay? Okay, guys, time for me to disappear out of here. Now, I've explained to Andrew what needs to be done, but all of you have got to pull together. You've got two great dogs and two very different dogs. One really needs our help. Up to you and the rest of the family to give it to him, okay?
Make sure he gets better.
Good on you. See you all later.
Thanks very much, Coyne.
Thanks
for seeing you later.